We've been putting new artwork into the faculty environment generally, and when you spend a little bit of time with it, it's a little bit destabilizing, a bit confronting. We want the art to sort of spark creativity and to get people to think, and I think these images are just enough unsettling to get people going. And we're just waiting for the complaint count to come up as my true indicator of whether we've been successful or not. I hung out down the beach like a stray dog. I had a bad, like a naughty childhood, I guess. Yeah, and wasn't academically focused at all. Just scraped through my high school certificate, got myself into university, and got sort of serious halfway through university. I had to do this insect collection of all things, and I'd never really looked at insects. And I got fascinated by it and started this obsession thing. And I got interested in mosquitoes, and again, that connection back to humans and human health and tropical diseases drew me in. Dengue is such a terrible problem around the world. 390 million people getting infected every year, that's the latest estimate. 2.5 billion people at risk, nothing working to control it, and it's getting worse. One of my core projects that I was most passionate about was the idea of taking this Wolbachia that shortened lifespan and put it into a mosquito, shorten its lifespan, so reduce its ability to transmit disease agents. And I thought it was a great, beautiful, elegant idea. I was getting small amounts of money which were able to keep the idea going. But when we got the Gates Foundation funding, it was like, a big bucket of money got dropped on us for the first time ever, and that allowed us to just accelerate greatly, and that's when it all started happening for us. So these are mosquito eggs that we collect. They're very tiny. That's what we had to inject to get the Wolbachia into the mosquitoes to start with. In recent years, we realised we didn't need to do anything to Wolbachia. We just need to have it in the mosquito, and it would actually interfere with dengue or malaria. And so everything became simpler. And when it became simpler, it became more possible to do it in the field. We had interactions with the scientists in Colombia, and they're getting ready to release mosquitoes probably within the next 6 months. This is some of the material that they've generated here, pamphlets that go out with their community engagement officers. They've even done it in Colombia, a school play, which I was privileged to see being performed. It's fantastic. Our dream, if you like, the big goal for us is to be able to make a really significant dent globally. And so we have an intervention that we think is looking like it could have big impact. And over the next 3 years, we want to test that impact directly and validate it. And if we're able to do that, then we want to scale it up to, more than 100 countries in 10 years if we can. It's made me more optimistic about the potential impact individuals can have, and it's possible to be quite ambitious and bold and actually pull it off. We've got really big problems in front of us, big problems coming up for this generation and the generations to follow. We need scientists to be the Prime Minister. We need scientists to be CEOs of major corporations. We need them to be running government departments. We need them to be management consultants. We need them in positions of influence. I think that this new generation coming through is quite special, and we need to make sure we nurture them properly. They're going to change the world.